seismic force for the system as shown here by dynamic analysis. M1 is 8. All the force are in terms of tons. Ton is 8 into 1000. You can multiply by 1000 and you will be getting in terms of kg. Like that, all the values are in terms of tons. Now the K is given here. K is stiffness. T, time period. For what purpose you need this? For finding seismic coefficient. How to find AH? First step is SA by G. So for that they have given the time period with respect to floors. And also they have given mode shape. Why? Because you have 4 number of floors. Page number 23, 7.7.5.4, you have simplified method of dynamic analysis. So here you have the steps. Formula is available. Mk, W into 5, this is G, summation of W, 5, Ik, the whole square. G is acceleration due to gravity, phi is mode shape coefficient at I floor, W is seismic weight, N is number of floors. This is the first step, model mass. This is W into 5. W into 5 is this column. You have to square this, divided by W 5 square. What is the first total percentage of weight? 84%. Next weight is 11.17, 3.98% and 1%. How to find this weight? You have to divide 20.32 divided by 24 into 100, that is in terms of percentage, 84%. The same way, divide 2.68 divided by 24 into 100, that is in terms of percentage, 11.17 you will be getting. Then next value is 0.957 divided by 24, 3.98%. Yes, then last value, 0.0249 divided by 24, 0.1%. Now you add all this percentage, you will be getting 100%. Check it. Also, the weight, if you add all the weight, it should be 24. See, the total mass is 24. You are adding all the 4 modes, the value should be 24. 20.32 plus 2.68 plus 0.957 plus 0.0249, 23.9, that is nearly 24. So this value and this should be equal. What is Pk? W into 5, this column is W into 5, this column divided by this, 4.55 by 0.999, you will be getting same 4.5, 1.63, 0.9, 0.158. And the third step will be design lateral force at each floor in each mode. You know the formula, I suffix k equals, this is acceleration coefficient. In the code book they have given, this is phi, known as mode shape. P is called participation factor and W is weight of the structure. You can get the formula from the code book. What is horizontal acceleration coefficient? That is Z by 2, I by R, SA by G. Now, what are the components you know in the given data? They have given phi, mode shape they have given. You have found out participation factor, 4.55, 1.63, 0.9 and 0.158. What are the data required? W. W is weight of the structure. They have given first floor is 8. Second floor is 8, then rest of the two floors are 4 and 4. In terms of tons, they have given. What is the only one unknown is the horizontal acceleration spectrum value. Now, how to find this? In given data, they have indicated the time period. T, this is for first floor, second floor, third and fourth floor. If they have given in matrix, you have to take like this. This is mode 1. For first floor, you have 1.3951. If this is the time period, if you check in the code book, you have two options. One for equivalent static method and another one for response spectrum method. Page number 9, you have the SA by G value. So you have two number of guideline here. The equivalent static method is a static AH and below that you have response spectrum method. Can you see in the code book? When this should be used is, if your time period is less than 0.1 second, T is lesser than 0.1 second. What are your values? Do you have any 0.1 second or below that? No, you don't have. Hence, you do not need to look into this. You can take the equivalent static analysis method. So, what is the first value? 1.3951. Rock and hard soil site. If in the given data they have not given, you can assume it as rock and hard soil sites. The value comes between 0.4 seconds to 4 seconds. Your SA by G will be 1 by T. So 1 by 1.3951. 0.716. What is second mode? 0.5916 second. 1 divided by 0.5916. Why we are using this? It is coming under the same case. Greater than 0.4 and less than 4 second. Hence 1 by 0.5916. 1.69. Third mode, what is the value? Which is coming 0.3729. It is coming below 0.4 second. Hence you can take what? 2.5 directly. SA by G will be 2.5. And for the last floor, the time period is 0.3. So 0.3 is less than 0.4 second. So you can take 2.5 SA by G. The next mode also 0.3019, less than 0.4, hence you can take SA by G is 2.5. Now, what are the other factors? You have found SA by G, importance factor is there. So, if you take importance factor, if the buildings which are coming around this category, you can take 1.5. If you are not knowing under which category, you can take IS1. Now, R, you have to find response reduction factor. Response reduction factor, it is generally an RC structure. It is good to take response reduction factor value as 5. Why? Because you are going to design, isn't it? When designing, you can build ordinary moment resting frame or special moment resting frame. It is suggested to do a special moment resting frame and take R value as 5. Last factor is zone. Z, you can assume it as zone 4. Assume zone 4. Now you know all the data. SA by G values are there. For zone 4, value of Z 0.24. Now you know the 5 value. What is A1? ZI divided by 2R. You have to substitute SA by G for all the coefficient. I will be 1 divided by R is 5. SA by G for first value is 0.716. Your value will be 0.0172. A2 is 0.0405. Rest of the values will be same. Only SA by G is going to change. You substitute 2.5, you will be getting A3, 0.06. Last value will also be the same, 0.06. See what is Q? A5P into W. You have found out all the acceleration coefficient for 4 floors. Now you know all the values. Right now you can find the values from this tabular column. Floor level, weight in terms of kilonewton, mode 1, 2, 3 and 4. 4 modes. And you can write acceleration coefficient below first mode, participation factor below first mode. Like that for second mode, third mode and fourth mode. 4 number of floors, 1, 2, 3 and 4. And what are the weights? Weights in terms of kilonewton. Now in given data, they have given in terms of tons. If you multiply by 9.81, you will be getting in terms of kilonewton. How to convert ton to kilonewton is into 9.81. You will be getting 78.5, 78.5, 39.24 and 39.24. Now you know first five value. What is 5-1? Mode shape 1 is 0.0914, 0.1872, 0.2643, 0.3056. This you can find out in given data. Now how you can find Q for first floor? Multiply A1, P1, W and 5. All the values you multiply and write it here. This is Q1. For second floor, the weight is going to change and 5 is going to get changed. A1, P1 is not going to get changed. It is the same. Then you can take down second mode, 0.1848, 0.2074, 0.0744, 0.3002. You have A2 and P2. Take these values. A2 is 0.0405, 5 is 0.1848, PK is P2, that is 1.63 into W1 is 78.5. You will be getting Q12. You are getting these values. From mode 3, the values will be 1.29 minus 0.76. Minus 0.3 and plus 0.3. The mode shape 4, 0.068 minus 0.1414 plus 0.3959 minus 0.2098. You have to multiply A into 0.0680 into 78.5. into 0.158. These are your four constants. Multiply your values will be 0.05 minus 0.843 plus 0.1462 and last value is minus 0.077. Now this is known as design lateral force on each floor. Next step, step D. Story shear force in each mode. Peak shear force VIK acting on a story I in K mode. Summation of I from 1 to N QIK. You have already found out QIK. How you can find out is the last value is not going to get changed. Q41 will be same. If you want to find VI1, it will be same 0.9301. And if you need for third floor, add these two value. Q31 plus 41. This is 31 and 41. You add these two and you have to write here. If you need for second floor, add the three forces and you can write it here. And at first floor, add all the forces and write here. This will be your answer. The same way you calculate for mode 2, 3 and 4. So maximum shear force for first floor is 3.4 kN. Second floor is 2.8, 1.7 and 0.93 kN. 0.7816 minus 0.1930 will be 0.5886. 0.5686 minus 0.7229. 0.0372 and 0.3467. The last value will be minus 0.7244, minus 0.7746, plus 0.0687 and minus 0.0775. Next step, last step is lateral force at each story by square root of sum of squares. This is a technique. Lateral force at each story due to all modes considered. Design lateral force, F for roof. This is roof force. Whatever value is there, you can take it as roof. Rest of the value, you have to subtract roof minus this value. Okay. How you are going to proceed this? This method. Sum root of sum of squares, SRSS method. What is this method? You have four number of floors, V1, V2, V3 and V4. These are the forces. how to take V1, take all the first values. 3.43, this value 3.4306, and next value is 1.06, then 0.5686, and last value is minus 0.7244. Square all this value and root this, you will be getting first answer. The same way, you square all the second values. This is the second value, 2.87 square plus 0.104 square plus minus, if you are squaring, will get this value minus 0.760, and last value is minus 0.746 square. Square all the values and root it, you will be getting the answers. For F roof, you will be getting 1.26 at roof, and if you subtract 0.73, 2.246, and last value 0.754.